What's something that you've never learned to do? Do a dad whistle using my fingers. Always wanted to do that shit. Edit. I just learned how to do it thanks to that first tutorial that was posted. Wah. Talk to people without them talking to me first. I always end up feeling left out on stuff. A person on Reddit said that you should ask about people's pets, because they will either talk excitedly about their pets or they will be against pets. Which leads you into another line of questioning. It's all a give and take about personal experiences. I've had success talking to people about video games, since so many people play them. Pets is a really good one, but I'm biased since I don't game. I also don't have pets, and wow, look, you didn't even ask, but here I am volunteering the info. Get out of bed the first time my alarm goes off. Get a cat. Feed the cat a half hour after your alarm would go off. The cat will wake you up 5 minutes before your alarm every day and will not give up on you. How to turn off cat during weekends. Greater than 5 minutes. That's conservative. Try an hour. Mine doesn't do it for food. She does it 'cause she just woke up after a day of sleeping and realizes that gives her energy and she can't contain it. My room becomes an Olympic obstacle course complete with her own very loud self-narration of a play. Flirt. Hey sweetie. Monsieur. Edit. Thank you kind stranger for the silver. There you go. Tie my shoes not using bunny ears. Do not give me that rabbit hole nonsense. It makes no sense. I'll die this way. I was really good at writing and speaking French back in school. Had aspirations to become fluent in the language and never really followed through on those aspirations. Now I barely remember how to construct a sentence. Omelette du fromage. Whoa man, I didn't know it was like that. Study. Like seriously, how to just sit and study for like several hours and do good without a breakdown. Every 50 seconds. Edit. A little late, but thanks to everyone who responded. The replies have amazing advice that'll definitely be helpful in my upcoming exams. Wish y'all the best if luck to hearts. University taught me two huge lessons in studying. I cannot study in a traditional sense as I lose focus and walk away to find something to keep my attention. To fix this, I would always study with a movie playing. Now, it could not be a new movie. Boring movie are my favorites. It needed to be a movie I enjoyed and knew well. This was so that I could turn and watch it for 5 minutes. Know exactly what was happening and easily return to my work without getting hooked. I have about 20 movies I have seen piecemeal an absurd amount of time. This would allow me to study for hours and effectively because the movie would occupy the portion of my mind that wasn't being taken by the work and would prevent daydreaming, walking away to find a roommate. The second is that I could not learn and take notes at the same time. I can only do one. So I picked learning. I would show that to class and take out no paper or laptop and just listen. If there was a group problem, I would participate. This would be a terrible decision as some courses, but I took engineering, so anything my professor was teaching already existed in the textbook. Duplicating the textbook in my notes seemed redundant, so I focused on understanding the material from class, then pounding out problems at home. All this is to say, don't try to teach yourself to study like you think you should study. Figure out how your mind learns. First year for me was rough, but my grades improved through the years as I figured out how to learn. Best of luck to you. You're going to crush studying. How to express anger and frustration in healthy, constructive ways. But I'm working on it. Edit. Man, this blew up. There's a lot to digest here. Thanks to everyone for the kind words, suggestions, and just general relatability. It's comforting to know that my struggle to be my better self is not unique. Thank you. You can be mad at, mad with, or mad about. I'm mad at my toaster, it burnt my toast. The toaster doesn't care. I'm mad with my toaster, it burns my toast. I said it wrong. I'm mad about my toaster, it's hard to get the setting right. The timer is not trustworthy. If you need to be mad, Okay, just be mad for a reason, and concentrate on communicating that reason. Breach of trust, unreasonable expectations, poor result, embarrassing surprise, etc. I hate what you did, what happened, versus I hate you. I'm sorry, sad face. Play a musical instrument. I have a bass guitar, but I'm just not understanding it. I'm confused. Do you want to be a musician or a bass player? I'm in this picture and I don't like it. Skate on ice, which may be my only disqualification to become PM of Canada. You should be okay if you learn curling and lacrosse. Hold the light just right for my dad. Whistle and snap edit. Holy shit, I didn't expect this comment to blow up LMAO. I've never figured out whistling either. Sometimes I do it by accident. But no matter how hard I try, I can't recreate it. How to deal with confrontation. My dad had anger issues when I was growing up and he would scream at us. It was terrifying, and now as an adult I don't know how to handle arguments with anyone. I just get so scared and anxious. Swim underwater without holding my nose. I wish I could, but I just haven't really been able to get the hang of it. I was around 8 or so on a cruise when an older boy, around 11 or 12, saw me holding my nose when I went underwater in the pool. And he sat with me for a while and taught me. We would practice by putting our hands on the edge of the pool and dunking ourselves underwater, and he told me to exhale through my nose over and over again until it stuck. Then, he swam with me. I'll never forget that boy and his kindness. If you're out there, sir, thank you. I still remember. I must be weird. I have never had an issue with water going up my nose unless I was hit by a particularly rough wave. This whole comment chain is bizarro to me. Some people are recommending holding your nose. Some people are saying to slowly but constantly breath out through your nose. Meanwhile, I'm over here just baffled that I had no idea this was a thing people faced when swimming. I guess it's kind of like how you have to focus on keeping your asshole clenched while underwater. Damn, until this thread I didn't know there were people who had to clench their asshole closed. Underwater, I feel like that's a lot to concentrate on. Especially since you have to make sure your dick and balls stay tucked between your legs. Drive. Don't worry, most people who do drive apparently never learned either. Man, it must be nice to live somewhere where driving isn't basically required. Tie a tie. I'm 32 and have worn a tie about 5 times in my life and have to Google it every time. Read and write good. I heard there's a center for that, but it's kinda small. I've always wanted to learn how to write. I write a lot for school and work. But damn, when I read other people's works, I'm constantly astounded. Edit. Wow, thanks for all the advice. Thanks also for the upvotes. Who would have thought my inadequacies were so universally shared? Head over to R Writing if you haven't already. The main thing you must do in order to write is write. It doesn't have to be good. It just has to be done. And much of writing is rewriting. Editing mostly. Also, read. Read a lot. Read good writing, but also read bad writing. Learn what works and what doesn't work. Read that crappy writing and then write a paragraph or two, rephrasing what you just read in a way that you like, and write what you know. If you know nothing of elves and dwarves and shit, but you know a ton about medieval Slavic history, don't write about the fucking elves and dwarves and shit. Write about medieval Slavic history. I wouldn't say there's much to learn. But I am 30 years old, and this summer will be the first time I have ever mowed a lawn. My older brother always did it. Edit. I'm fairly new to Reddit, and this is the first time I've blown up like this. Thanks, everyone. I'm the older brother in this situation. I'm going to laugh when my spikes brat of a younger brother has to do this stuff himself. Going to sleep at a reasonable time. Been like this since I was teen and I don't see it changing anytime soon. Been that way more or less since I could talk. I had a bedtime when really young, but I'd play or read in bed. Parents eventually gave up trying to force the issue. sleeping just always seemed like a waste of time. Especially at night, when things were quiet and you could get stuff done. Make friendships last. Find something truly worth doing. Truly and deeply care about something or someone. I really want to understand how electricity works. Like volts and amps and current and watts and all that stuff. I've read and watched videos, but it just doesn't click for me. Try the book, There Are No Electrons. It reads more like a novel than a textbook. Swimming. Had an abusive swimming instructor who would hold me under the water if I made a mistake or stopped swimming. Since then, I am 20 and still scared of swimming cause the drowning traumatized me. Edit. Thanks for the support, guys. I am surprised that there are many other people who had gone through something like this, and I sympathize with you all. And to everyone offering swim lesson, just want to say thank you. But I am currently very busy right now. WTF, did you report that shit? Not sure. I was 7 to 8 at the time, so no idea what anyone did. I had an abusive dentist at ages 7 to 12. Never told my mom because I thought it was normal to get fillings without anesthesia. I hope he's burning in hell. I had the same issue back in the 50s. Our family dentist was a sadistic child molester. He would reuse an empty anesthetic syringe's decoy and to save money. He would just stab away in your mouth, same needle for days and dozens of patients. He finally got arrested after he knocked out some girl, and when he called 911 cause he couldn't revive her, the ER doctors found her training bra on backward and cross-hooked. He suicided with ether in his garage, laying on the beams so he would fall and hang himself. Draw. Really wanted to be an artist. But life pushed me in another direction. I still want to draw. Even professionally one day. But I have no teacher and I'm extremely poor. When I was 8-ish, I used to glue the tiny bit of pencil lead back onto another piece so I could use it. Didn't have paper. So I used to dumpster dive for sheets that weren't spoiled. Edit 1. Hey, thank you so much for the positivity. Let me clear some things up. I'm poor still, but I'm much better off. I've actually found a stash of unused art stuff my mom had. So there's my starting point. I'm going to try and draw one object a day. Anything I see, hopefully with the suggestions I have. Like draw a box. I will get to a decent point and I'll try to work up from there. Thank you all. Any advice is greatly appreciated. Greater than it, I'm extremely poor, you're halfway to being a professional artist already. Winking face. Ride a bike. LMAO. I thought I was alone in the world. It's shocking to people every time it comes up. It just never really came up as a kid, so I never got a bike. Never learned. Knew I couldn't be the only one. Learn a new language. Have tried multiple times and ways but can't seem to stick with it, which sucks because I would love to be able to speak fluently in a second language. 1. Travel to France. 2. Throw passport away. 3. 4. Profit. 1. Travel to Korea. 2. Throw passport away. 3. 4. Bujaga Dazabzio, Jiwanun Hangjio Gongbolo Hiyo. There's my limit for you. Forgive. That's a tough one. It helps if you learn to accept people for who they can be and try not to hold against them who they aren't. Also, I've learned only a select few deserve access to outside the box. Basic socializing, it's all a mystery to me, and I'm in my 30s. I was shy as a kid. I'm still an introvert, but I feel as though I am good at socializing. Here are my steps. Step 1. Ask a question about the person's life. Step 2. Listen to person's response. Step 3. Ask follow-up questions. I failed step 1. 60 years old and socially awkward as hell. I've kind of given up. Feeling for people who have recently lost someone in their life. Death. Breakups. Etc. I have a robotic response and have trouble feeling sympathetic. Not because I don't want to, but because it doesn't come naturally at all. Some lady at my job lost her mom and was out all last week. I don't even know what to do when she walks by me or talks to me about something else now that she's back. I feel like a normal person would tell her I'm sorry for her loss, but it feels awkward to me to even bring it up. If that's the case, act totally normal. Plenty of people are offering her sympathy, and some are probably taking it over the top because some people like to make everything about attracting attention to themselves. She probably wants to get back to work and return to a sense of normalcy and will appreciate you just being normal, assuming you are normally a decent person. If you're normally a jerk, go a little easy on her for a while. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.